Two of the three integrated function display IFD screens on the Amtrak P-42 are located on the engineer's control console. The IFDs are the primary method with which the engineer receives the information required to operate the train safely and efficiently. The locomotive speed is displayed in both digital and graphical formats. An acceleration pointer or predictor calculates what the speed will be in 1 minute if operating conditions remain unchanged. The load meter indicates motoring and braking amperage in both digital and graphical formats. The air brake information zone contains air brake equipment operating pressure. Both the brake pipe pressure and the equalizing reservoir pressure are displayed in digital and graphical formats. The regulating valve setting is indicated by graphical triangles. Brake cylinder pressure, reduction pressure, last car pressure, and the main reservoir are displayed in a digital format. Operation warning lights illuminate if conditions outside the normal operating range occur. Fault messages are displayed identifying the problem area and explaining the trouble in more detail. Most operating functions are set up and controlled from the IFDs. These include cruise control, the electronic air brake regulating valve setup, and the end of train setup. System tests can be performed from the IFDs and status information is available. These tests include the cab signal test, the air brake departure test, the alerter magnet valve test, and the speed check. The update information includes the fuel monitor status and the distance counter. Pressing the full screen brightness push button next to the right engineer's screen restores all IFD screens to maximum brightness. The MU emergency shutdown push button switch shuts down all of the MU'd locomotives in the consist. The button must be set to the run position to restart the unit. The spotter push button is pressed to move a locomotive using only battery power, such as in a shop area. The diesel engine may or may not be running. The cab signal overspeed display panel has a warning light, a son alert, and a selector switch. The front and rear headlight switches have four positions: off, dim, medium, and bright. If the train is equipped with a two-way end-of-train device at the rear of the train, throwing the EOT rear emergency brake switch vents the brake pipe from the rear of the train at an emergency rate. The crossing light selector switch turns on the crossing lights in a non-flashing mode. The parking brake applied indicator informs the engineer of the parking brake status. The parking brake must be released before normal operation. The slow speed devices control the slow speed backing operations. These include the enabled indicator, the backing push button, and the backing excitation controller. Refer to the operator's manual for additional information on the operation of slow speed backing. The lower console contains additional operating circuit breakers. The engine run breaker must be on to control diesel engine speed. The generator field breaker permits control of the generator output. The control breaker provides power to train line control positive. The dynamic brake circuit breaker allows control of the dynamic braking output through the combined power handle. These breakers should be on for lead operation and off for trail operation. In push service, only the control breaker is on. The gauge light toggle switch is at the end of the row of circuit breakers. The window heater, the power limit switch, and the step light switches are located below. The power limit switch limits power to notch 7 on the lead locomotive. This function is not train-lined. The heater air conditioner control switch selects between various heater and air conditioner settings. The air conditioner control knob allows the engineer to set the temperature of the air coming from the heater and the air conditioner. The train line ground reset push button silences the electronic air brake alarm. This receptacle provides 74 volts DC. The gauge lights may be adjusted to compensate for lighting conditions in the cab. The floor-mounted horn sequencer switch integrated to the onboard computer system is operational when the locomotive is traveling above 1/2 mile per hour. One press starts the horn sequence that also activates the bell and crossing lights. The horn sounds 2 long, 1 short, and 1 long blast. The bell rings and the crossing lights alternately flash. Pressing the horn sequence foot switch again silences the horn. You must press the bell button to stop the bell. The crossing lights continue to flash for 30 seconds. The floor-mounted radio foot switch permits the engineer to use the radio when wearing a headset. The center console contains the HEP control panel, the radio, and handset. There is an emergency brake valve push button on the left side of the console. Pushing the button initiates an emergency brake application. To reset, you must pull out the button. Beneath the radio are the cab floor lighting switch that controls the lights that are located where the floor height changes, and the cab dome light switch. The cab signal aspect display is above this console. This unit displays the cab signal aspect as received electronically from the track. There is a switch on the top of the display that must be set according to the cab signal territory in which you are operating. The Qualcomm train communication controller sends and receives data. Caution: the engineer must never access this device while operating the locomotive. The entrance to the nose compartment is located below the center console. The operating air to the front sand magnet valves may be cut out using the cutout cock located in the nose compartment. The assistant engineer's console is fitted with the unit's third integrated function display. Although it is used to monitor locomotive performance, such as measured mile, fuel monitor, the distance counter, and perform diagnostic tests, other operator functions are disabled. A horn button is to the left of the IFD screen. Below the horn button is the assistant engineer's headset station. A clipboard is built into the desktop. A radio handset for the assistant engineer is to the left of the console. A 110-volt AC receptacle is at the bottom of the left side of the console. Let's start back at the engineer's control console and look at some of the operator's cab sealing devices. A visor is provided to reduce the nighttime glare from the IFD screens in the side mirror. Above the engineer's area are the engineer's light controls, the engineer's desk light and switch, and the engineer's reading light and switch. The audio-visual alarm AVB box is located above the center control console. This device provides audible tones and flashing lights when the alerter, locomotive overspeed, or end-of-train device requires the engineer's attention. The area above the assistant engineer's console is fitted with desk and reading lights and devices similar to those above the engineer's control console. An auxiliary headset station and dome light are located in the center area of the cab ceiling. Operator cab equipment is located conveniently within easy reach of the crew members. The engineer's headset station is located near the bottom right wall of the operator cab. A first aid kit along the wall and two fire extinguishers, one behind the engineer's seat and one behind the helper's seat. Windshield wiper controls are mounted along the engineer's and assistant engineer's side walls. A push button activates the windshield washer. The parking brake controller applies and releases the parking brake. If there is no main reservoir pressure, the parking brake may be manually released after the wheels are chocked. The dead engine feature also can be cut in to release the parking brake if the brake pipe pressure is above 90 psi. The parking brake must be released before operating the locomotive. The auxiliary cab heater provides additional heating when required, such as during cold morning startups. The refrigerator, powered by 110 volts AC, functions when the head-end power is operating. There are three air conditioner heater vents in the operator's cab. In addition to a vent next to both the engineer and the assistant engineer, there is a vent above the EC panel behind the engineer's cab seat. The windows are tinted, and sunshades are provided to reduce glare to improve visibility and increase crew comfort. Mirrors help monitor train conditions. A fresh air damper allows the fresh air supply to the cab to be shut off in extreme weather. The dead engine cutout cock, the bell cutout cock, and the control air cutout cock are located beneath the operator's cab floor.